global video distribution and monetization network Rightster has broadcast its interim results today. And one journalist that I work with has described the 262% increase in net revenue as eye-popping. Well, higher top-line growth across all four of its geographic regions in the first half comes after acquisitions of Base 79 and VML, as well as the appointment of a new chief executive in January. And that new chief executive, well, not so new now, Patrick Walker, joins us now. So, Patrick, acquisitions, cost-cutting, new products, new clients, how have you managed it all?
It's been a very exciting time and a very busy period since I took over as CEO in January and Niall Dorr as CFO as well. We're no strangers to this industry, to this business. In fact, I was involved obviously with Base 79 prior to, so it's just part of an ongoing journey, really. Acquisitions are made. We spent a lot of time focusing on the integrations, cross-training teams, taking out a lot of cost, actually, both in terms of some of our engineering center in Bangalore, reducing some of the headcount, consolidating, and also hiring in some really great new folks as well to join the team that here representing the various aspects of the business. So it's been a very exciting time. We're pleased with the results. We're only 50% there, though. We're, a long way to go still in terms of the journey, but we feel we're making good progress.
Okay, you mentioned acquisitions there. They're already contributing to revenue. Does Rightster feel like a different business now?
Rightster is a combined business, if you like, between the best of YouTube channel management, brand relationships, know-how from Base 79 historically, from technology platform and off YouTube distribution capabilities from Rightster background, and from storytelling with user-generated content and working with creative agencies at scale was the viral spiral background. So actually what we are now is a highly technologized media tech business that is really focused on the future, really in the middle of a very hot market and transformation, very disruptive period for media businesses that are looking to capitalize on emerging video platforms. And we're very pleased with the integration and proud of our accomplishments, but it is a daily exciting battle out there, and we're enjoying it.
Okay, so you're now focused on more high profile international brand and content partnerships, but won't this result in longer lead times on certain deals?
Correct. We spent a lot of time not just looking at the future and how we're going to integrate the sort of plans, find the partners, renew the partners that have the best, collaborative relationships and good for our margin as well. We've also spent time removing some non-profitable deals from the past, freeing ourselves, if you like, from some of these relationships that predate the new management and getting into a much healthier shape. That is in part why we've taken down the guidance slightly to 70-80% year-on-year growth, which is still very healthy, particularly with all the costs we've taken out. It is really still a business that is focused on growth, but it's in transition. We believe, though, that particularly with the massive transformation and shift of TV spend into digital platforms where we are active, there's a big growth story still to come.
Okay, you say you're getting into healthier shape, but this year's revenue will still be below targets.
We have set out at the beginning of the year, we said 80 to 100% year-on-year growth. We are now saying 70 to 80, but that's on the basis of double the amount of cost savings we anticipated, from 3 to 6 million, a higher reduction in headcount and consolidation of the teams, reduction in the burn rate by 40%. So when you do that and you go into such a transformation and you're in a very rapidly transforming industry, we need to adjust gears to some extent. And that is why we've taken a more conservative approach at this point and brought it down. But that being said, these are companies coming together. We've already demonstrated in the first half of the year 81% underlying growth, which is very solid, particularly at this big time of transformation. So we just feel we want to be out there, open with the market, communicate with them regularly as best we can, and talk about the good work that's gone on, and looking for enthusiasm going forward.
So it's a time of transformation. I'm wondering if that's the reason you've said that you're looking to secure additional investment in quarter four. You know, is this a priority? Do you need to do this? And if so, will this be equity funding?
We are always on the lookout for diversifying the investor base as we grow. You know, we are still very much in growth mode. We constantly will review the cash flow break-even plans versus making sure we go for growth opportunities that require some investment. For us, the job is only partially done in terms of the significant transformation that we've been leading for this part of the year so far. It's a good opportunity to get involvement from those who actually are excited about the space that we're in, and diversifying that that group of investors is an important part of our future.
Patrick Walker, Chief Executive of Rightster, thank you very much indeed for joining us today.
Thank you.